Oh.
Neil,
hey.
My feet
guys.
Are killing me.
Have any luck?
No sign of anyone else. But we did find plenty of bloodthirsty wildlife and crumbling ruins.
Long day?
Well, guys, we've run out of places to search around here. Where's Hope?
He's off with the chocobo, getting supplies. Hello.
You all by yourself?
He's Brent.
What?
We gotta find him.
Hey everyone, Opaque Flake here, welcome you back to the year of Final Fantasy with Final Fantasy 13. Holy shit! That was epic, wasn't it? I love that cutscene. Going right after Bahamut. And it's nothing. So, if you ask me, I have like a small, I guess, callback to the Midgar slums when they're walking down that path after they defeat Bahamut. Which is why I kind of give like a look around. I don't know, I mean, I thought it kind of reminded me of it. It's kind of beautiful in a sense. Makes you wonder how the 7 remake's gonna look like in the end. Got a few more things to mention, but right now, let's go save Hope and meet some Grand Post natives, in a sense. Like these Aeron? Yeah, I guess Aeron. Aeron Hubbard. Damn, Snow's already dead. So they get for not distributing any CP to them. But what I really need to do is not distribute CP, but switch party, because Snow, again, he's more of a Ravager and Sentinel than a Commando. But that's the benefit that he has. He's the only Sentinel within post gameplay that can go Ravager out of two Sentinels, of course. So, maybe against fire and blizzard, and here I am using thunder. It's because it's the only AoE attack I have. But yeah, out of the two, he's the only one who can go Ravager, so if you want Tridisaster and want a Sentinel, well there you go. That's your only decision you have in the meantime for post-game until you, well, beat the game and then play after that. Also, the same can be said with Saz and Hope with synergy. Do you want buffs or do you want buffs to protect you? Buffs to attack, buffs to defend. And the same can be said with Vanille and Fang. Buffs to attack, buffs to defend. And in between Vanille, Lightning, and Hope is how much of a healing do you want? Do you want powerful heals? You go with Vanille. Do you want okay heals? You go with Lightning. Do you want a balance between the healing? I guess Red Majory, you would go with Hope. His heals aren't that bad though. It's just that he really is a Red Mage. He has the buffs. He has some nice powerful black magic. And he has some pretty decent healing magic. So these are the Flan. Normal, boring Flan. Not a huge fan of Flan, as in the food. Apparently they're weak against fire. So depending on your party, on what you want to go with for post game, I think the best really is Fang, Lightning, and Hope. Because you got powerful black magic, you got a good balance of attack and Ravager in those two attacks, and a healer in Lightning, and then you got your Sentinel, your debuffer, which could be better. But if it was, then Vanilla would be useless. In Fang. Also, she hits pretty hard. She hits harder than Snow. Again, Snow's thing is to be Ravagery for Tri-Disaster. Alright, I changed my team so I can get that back attack. So I might as well do it. And the CP here is around 1,000 now. That's a big flan. Alright, let's do it. Shouldn't be too tough. I was hoping you would do a regular attack for power chain, but that'll work, I guess. Look at all them debuffs. Also, fog, what it does is it keeps... Well, not keeps. I'll just say it this way. It's pretty much silence. Honestly, surprised you killed him. Also, I think I need to learn Braze with my Vanilla. Oh, by the by, Vanilla already has her fourth ATB gauge. You can learn it as soon as the Crystal Armor expands. Right before you fight Cid, that chapter. Chapter 10. But you have to go all the way out with the medic to get there, so... It's the first one, though. So it's not that bad. So this is a dire flan. Susceptible to slow and delivers devastating physical attacks. Vanilla can tell you firsthand how devastating they are. I'm gonna go with this team only because... Why not? Ooh, a partisan. Staple weapon. That's it. Nothing to help you out in terms of damage. And Fang really doesn't need magic at all. I mean, you could do damage with Saboteur. Unless you want to make her caster with Ravager later on in the game. But for the most part, you really don't need it. Anyways, let's go help out Hope. Because his mark is going apeshit.
So this is how it ends. But
just wait. Now, how long has it been since we left Cocoon? Not a single soul for miles around? Not a single clue about this whole sea mess? What I'm saying is, we did well just getting this far.
But we could go a little further.
Meaning?
There's still one place.
Vanille? Are you sure?
I'm sure.
You know, if we don't find anything this time, we won't get another chance.
Huh? Erba.
Hey.
The place it all began.
Hope.
The place where the pulse of Falci lay dreaming. Vanille and Fang's home. Just maybe. It'll be the place where we find the answers we're looking for.
Yeah, right. If we can get there.
Go ahead without me.
We can't just leave you.
I'll be fine. You've all taught me so much. You showed me how to fight.
What did I tell you? Leave the fighting to me.
I'm scared.
We understand. You're not gonna go through this ordeal alone, you know. Huh?
That's what scares me. I don't want to see you get hurt because of me. It'd be better for everyone if I just stayed behind.
Hey!
Mention ordeals? And look what comes along!
This is not an ordeal. This is a gift. Hope!
What?
This is the kind of power you've got inside. And it's telling you not to give up. Trust me.
Huh? Oh, I get it. It's here to show you the way. Show you that you've got what it takes to get back on your feet and do this thing!
You mean... that came from me?
Ready?
Got a little retry. Alright, since we're fighting an Eidolon, you're gonna need a lot of health, since Hope is the one who has to lead the front. Which is why I retried, because I could get a little bit more health if I go to Medic. And some magic, so that's always good. I think Ravager didn't finish as well. Yeah, these cost a little bit. That's a 15 fucking magic, holy shit. And I already gave him that, forgot already. So let me see what I'm working with. Nothing but sentinels on fucking Fang, why? I mean, that should work, but one more synergist wouldn't mind. This should do it. And I'll start off with... Combat Clinic. Because, of course, we are fighting none other than the great... Alexander. So Riot Shield's actually a really great paradigm for this fight. Because unlike Libra Scope, Libra just gives you the smaller gist of what to do. But here you still have to uncover what the notes are. But if you think about it, most of the Eidolon fights have been either defend, heal, or chain bonus. But in this one, it's pretty much be a healer and you're good. I didn't want to do that, but too late now. Wanted Veil. Yeah, that's Fang since she's leading right now. Did it just cast it on Fang twice? I thought it did it on Hope. Yeah, well. So when he challenges you, that's when you attack. And then right after that challenge, he's gonna start attacking you. That's when you go to Combat Clinic. Or something with the Sentinel Medic. Because it's not showing yet. It's gonna say a mass to those who heals others or something like that. Well, there's a challenge, so attack for a bit. By the way, pay attention to how Alexander fights, because his combos are pretty fucking awesome. Ow. Taunt, 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 ta taunt, taunt, ta taunt. I was hoping she would throw at least one debuff, but guess not. This should do it though. Oh shit, this is gonna be a close one. Alexander's fucking huge. Basically a huge ass wall.
That's some beast you tamed, I'll tell you that.
Yeah. I always thought the Eidolons appeared to set us free through death. But now, I think maybe they're here to snap us out of our slumps.
Oh, like the one you were just in?
I'll ask for help earlier next time around.
I told you, on Grand Pulse, we're all family. You can moan all you like, but you're stuck with us.
You're never alone in hell.
Listen, funny man, don't call this place hell, all right?
So, we're all decided then.
Yeah.
Yep. Maybe nothing would change. And maybe we'd hit a dead end. But we were at least going to see where the road would take us. The search for a home buried in the past, and the faintest glimmer of hope. Our final journey had just begun.
Let's go.
This stone, it's...
Look familiar? It's a kind of seeth. It's in the last stage.
A seeth?
Don't worry. It's no threat to anyone anymore. The Seed that fail their focus become Seed and wander the wilds. Eventually, they lose the will to go on and turn to stone. But still, even in this state, they can't forget the task they once had.
And they call out to the Seed, over and over, complete my focus.
So they're doomed to eternal regret, huh?
Hey, we should help this one out. Come on, we can't just ignore it. Listen, if we fail our focus, it could be us suffering like that.
Wow, what a happy thought. That's not like you.
But going out of his way to help someone? That's snow all over.
So other than the lore, this is basically a subquest. That's pretty much all there is to it. And I really like how they explain it too, like the lore to it, how these things come to exist. They're not just random stones, there's a purpose to it. So that's pretty cool.
I think it's starting to sink in. We're home.
So, mission one, pond scum. Ecto pudding is the mark. In the Arc Yelp Steep, Central Expanse. It's kind of cool, the text they have is like, this is their thoughts on what they must do. You can only take on one or... The only downside is you can only take on one at a time. So, take that as you will. But it's not too tough. I think the game also marks it for you if you have enough map. Oh no, it already marks it for you. But this place is huge. Like... That's Oerba, or Erba, I think that's what they pronounce it. This is where we're at. It's pretty fucking huge. By the cutscene where they kill the chocobo. I thought that was a brutal death for the chocobo. But no, I've seen worse. Well, at least to me it was brutal, but... Goddamn, I'll never see a chocobo the same way ever again. But yeah, man, Grand Pulse. This is one huge ass of overworld. This is what Final Fantasy 13 should have been originally, and this is what Final Fantasy 15 might be, one big ass area, which is pretty cool if you think about it. All right, I gotta fix these again. At least I got slow gun. So the fourth attack on Fang is give or take cool. I'm kind of like eh, but at the same time it's like okay. I mean, you can't do much with the spear, so who am I to complain? You monster. I have a lot of either souls, so I don't mind. I'm surprised I haven't used any yet. And there you go. It's just like the counter. Again, not much you can do with the spear. So I was like, eh. The only downside is it's not... Oh, it's a multiple attack strike, so it's okay to shift out of it. It's just, I think Saz's and Vanille and Lightning's are the best. I should show off Hope soon, though. I don't really remember it. But damn, man, 15. I really can't wait to see how that's gonna turn out in terms of overworld and towns and all that fun stuff. You can think of this place as Calmlands as well, but Calmlands is fucking tiny compared to this. And there's actually more to do here than just a few mini games. This one's gonna be crucial right now. Because we have a huge ass flan here. And I would summon Bahamut, but I don't have Bahamut. Come on. Provoke the fucking dire flan already. It doesn't want to be provoked. Alright, I'll get the full heal instead. But definitely the fights become a lot more threatening here. And since we're not on the run anymore in Cocoon, we can actually explore and run around and all that fun stuff. Even though you're on a timer. Borrowed time, as Snow puts it. But now that I'm playing this game again, I kind of feel like this is probably the journey that the Black Mages from Final Fantasy IX would have went through. Considering the predicaments and circumstances, I guess, of the world. Like, they were created for a purpose, and then eventually, well, they don't choose to fight. They do later on, but that's pretty much what's going on. These, now that I think about it, this is also kind of like Xenoblade Chronicles in a sense. They're born in a world of strife, they choose to fight, and then something worldly slash. And I don't know the rest of that quote. But no, in all seriousness, that's pretty much it. They're just humans who just, you know what? You created us, that's cool and everything, but what the fuck, man? Our only purpose is not just to pass the butter. And for anyone who doesn't know what I'm referring to in that quote, Rick and Morty. Keep on forgetting to jump off ledges. So this one absorbs lightning damage. That's actually a good accessory, but I don't know any bosses right now or enemies that do a lot of lightning damage. Really foggy over here, man. But remember Sunless Waterscape? Like, imagine exploring all that? Well, you can finally do it now. No, 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 no. By the way, that big thing that ate that adamantoise, Tortoise? Whatever. You can fight that. I fought that before. It only lasted like 2 seconds, but I fought that. Nah, fuck. They came up me bum. I don't know how I got Prince Strike, but I got it. Now I got a Sloga. So there are a few enemies you can fight here that you can actually fight, to put it that way. And I don't have enough for a summon, so I guess I'll just go with Renew. But most of the stuff here can kill you really quick if you don't know what you're fighting. The Adamant Turtoise, I guess. Tortoise? Adamant Tortoise. What am I saying, Turtoise? Adamant Tortoise. They'll kill you quick. Even the smaller ones can still kill you. So seriously, just be careful and only fight what you know you can fight. You can technically fight King Behemoth here, and you can beat them, but you just gotta be really good with what you're doing and keeping them in the air, because if they stand on their hind legs, you are fucked. Because I think that's what's running around right now, the King Behemoth. There should be an item around here too. But it's only been about 20 hours. Yeah, 20 hours to reach Grand Post. I know a lot of people can beat this game really quick, but you gotta consider that I've been cutscenes and whatnot. Alright, I need something for that. I think you gotta do a sub quest for it. Makes you wonder what kind of ferocious beast they really are. Like that one, I think it was Peter Puppy from Earthworm Jim. You step on his tail and he transforms into something that would wreck your shit. Damn, it just switched everything back. It wasn't even like the Alexander roll. It just switched everything back. So here's our goal. And as you can tell, there's another, thief stone there. Damn, I really do hope fog does land, because no magic is good. Employs powerful water-based attacks. There you go. Now all I need is slow. Curse is fine too, but slow mostly. Oh, both of them. That's even better. Alright, let's heal up. Because it's Ecto Pudding, man. Gotta love Curse. Don't attack. Curse at its finest, preventing it from attacking. There you go. I don't remember the rest, but you can take on the mission more than once, I believe. So I got an energy splash, which is pretty cool, I guess. I'm not going to show off the rest, but these seed stones, they do amass to a lot of chain bonuses.
Makes Cocoon feel like a chocobo coop.
Like, not chain bonuses, sorry. They're like chain quests. So, eventually, you'll get a lot of that. Getting a back attack on these is fucking hilarious, too. This is an Adamant child. But essentially, it's the weakest of the bunch. And I'm just showing you what it could really do.
You kidding me?
So yeah, even the weakest ones can fuck you up. And I know you're thinking, what if you get a preemptive strike? You'll be good. Nah, you need stats. I think that's the second one. So that's an adamant child. That's an adamant toys, I believe. And the adamant tortoise is somewhere else, I believe. But right now, let's go look for that big as fuck monster. Shouldn't take too long. Because there are some side quests here that are really good for you. And I only remember two, but they're not here here. They're in a cornering spot. That's a big lobo. I don't know if they're called lobos here. Maybe they're called a Fenrir. But that shit's huge. And you can fight things in the sky. It's just kind of hard to provoke them. I should be able to handle these. These are mechanoids, I believe. That was weird. Oh, these are goblins. Okay. These should be good CP as well. Yeesh. You saw that attack? With both of them, that did like a fuck ton. So, you get that punch? Does it sound familiar? It's Goblin Punch. Oh shit, no, I don't want to do that. Now I'm fucked. I am fucked. Yeah, I can't beat him. But yeah, those are goblins, and I fucked up. I wanted to do a renew, because I could have been able to take them out, but again, I fucked up. There's an item I missed, by the way. It's right here. No, it's a stone. It's somewhere around here. Either that or it could be mistaken for Final Fantasy 12. Again, I played the big ass desert in 12, which is the very beginning of the game. Like twice and then I stopped. Those type of JRPGs had not enticed me. I was all into turn-based. But either or not, people still love turn-based combat. But I guess the newer kids would be like, nah, this shit sucks. I need to move around and actually press button. It feels like I'm doing something. And that's where Tales of Games come in handy, I guess. But nah, you can do turn-based, right? Fucking Valkyrie Profile. My go-to example every time. It's just beautiful. Because it's to the point where it's not tedious, like the OG Tyson games or Project X Zone, where you have to do nothing but juggles in order to win. Don't get me wrong, you gotta do that in Valkyrie Profile, especially in later in the game, but it's not that extensive, I guess. Don't get me wrong, you gotta do that in Valkyrie Profile, especially later on in the game, but it's not that extensive. To the point where it fucking takes forever, even in the beginning of the game. But these are my complaints and my complaints alone. Long walk for an item. Ooh, perfect. Just what I needed. That's Erba, by the way. I remember that map. I think I mentioned it in my Majin and the Forsaken Kingdom Let's Play. That it reminded me of a video game. And then I remember right away what it reminded me of. By the way, chapter 11, Grand Pulse, this one right now, it's a really fucking big chapter. Like, it's really huge. It's a really big chapter, because Grand Pulse is so fucking huge. Speaking of which, That's how big cattle blippas are gonna be in Final Fantasy 15, and that just makes me all hard inside. Patience, the key to getting preemptive strikes or back attacks. Either or. But really gonna need it for this fight. These guys are actually pretty tough, but they're also good CP. So we got Layax, and I don't know where the other one is. And I already killed it. Well, whatever it is, it's a blue Layak. Again, really useful here, and they're good CP. 25 easy. But most importantly, an item. There you are. Smooth hides. And then there's those guys. Let's see if I can get a back attack on them. Rongda. That's what they're called. Okay. So, susceptible to fog and vulnerable to ice damage. I should be doing fog instead then. Which is super fog. Instead of slog, of course, but oh well, too late now. And Rengdas are vulnerable to ice damage, and I assume susceptible to fog as well. I mean, they are casters, so. Let's try that. I was hoping Fogo would be enough, but apparently not so. And now you can't do shit. Like, oh my god! I can't do shit! Better back away slowly and they caught up to me, fuck! I don't know. But those are the enemies like, I think they're called Larvae in Final Fantasy X of the Thunderplanes. When you silence grenades, they couldn't do jack shit. So there you go. Oh, and I guess the elementals as well. An ice charm. Absorbs ice. Alright. It's a long walk over there, so I'm just gonna keep quiet and you can enjoy the scenery. Because there is a lot of nice scenery here. After this battle, of course.
See that?
Oh man, it's a behemoth king. And this is a Megistotherian. No, focus the Meggy. You don't want to fuck with the behemoth king. God damn it. Fuck it, might as well kill the king. If I can. He's gonna get on his hind legs, and it's gonna be brutal. I better buff up. Youch. And that's why you don't mess with the behemoth king. This guy's like, I heard you were talking shit. He's not even doing anything anymore. He's like, I give up. Anyway, he's not really gonna fuck with that. Just wants to show it off. You can't do it, but yeah. All the tougher enemies are right here and up here. And there's a bunch of items over there too. I don't know how good they were. It's been a while. But yeah, just worth noting that. Again, these guys are doable to kill, it's just that I'd rather not. At least not right now. You can't activate this yet.
There's a way through here!
Alright, this is gonna take you out of the Arkguild Steep. Into some caverns, like Mushroom Rock in a sense. Well, it's gonna look like Mushroom Rock, but not by a lot. It's still gonna have some vegetation on there.
I don't know about this.
That there's gonna be more dialogue. But this should be like the Abyssal Ruins or something like that. Or Abyssal Cavern. Something around there. Something abyss. Yeah, now you see something. Alright, more mechanoids. Hoplite. I'm honestly really weak right now though. Like really weak. The game kind of expects you to be top shit by now. And I think in my first initial playthrough I was, but that's because I fought everything. Here, did skip quite a bit. Can't provoke them, Captain. Alright, let's go with the Sloga. I got one of them. So these hot blades are resistant to ice, and that's about it so far. Pretty sure they're weak against thunder, but I guess no one's casted it yet. Yep, thunder. You know what we should really get is Chrysaga. I think you can go back and grab that. I don't know if I skipped it, but if I did, I can always go back and grab it. It shouldn't cost too much CP.
Easy.
Two-star rank and I got 2300. That was easy. And a hot declare. Stagger lock. A lot of damage, but it can put you in stagger. Well, looks like I'm playing the waiting game. Man, didn't even turn around. I was forced to fight them head on. This one's gonna turn around. Yes, perfect, perfect, perfect. And they turn around slow, even better. Man, these guys are easy to kill and are easy 2 to 3,000 CP. I remember what I said about those little implings. These are the things you should kill. Yeah, let's go this way. There might be an item. Or ice bombs. Ice bombs are a thing too. I have no idea how I didn't get a back attack. I don't know if I'm gonna survive either, but I have a sentinel, so it's possible. Why are you using ice? Why? They look like ice. Well, then again, they're AI. As soon as I kill it, though, the information shall be revealed. They're not weak against water, are they? No, they're not. I guess the guy really didn't know. Nice try.
Are you sure that's the right way?
Shit! That was a good amount of CP. I hope this is the right way for the item, though. Yeah, it looks like it. I mean, the other one was the objective, so, yeah. Man, this is such easy CP. Holy shit. And holy shit indeed. Now, you know what? I think I'll wait for this. 3,850 CP. And that battle was like 15 seconds. Well, holy shit. Didn't think it'd be a mini boss battle. But the Juggernaut. High damage dealing potential, employs powerful fire-based attacks, delivers devastating physical attacks capable of removing status ailments. Basically the last boss we fought, but a lot more fucking harder. As you can see. Alright, let's try this again now that I have Ember Rings on. And I know what to expect, so... let's see if I can do this. Ember Rings plus spending about 38,000 CP, as well as having Medic and protecting against fire right now, the fire debuff. It should be good. But for the most part, I just need the buffs. Right now, I need the buffs. Are you dumb buffing? You really are dumb buffing. All right. Now it's my turn to debuff. As long as it gets some slower curse, I should be good. If I had pain, I don't know if that would help though. What pain does is it keeps him from acting, as in no physical attacks. Whereas fog keeps him from doing magic attacks. This fight's gonna be a while. Look how much damage we're doing. But yeah, this fight's gonna take a while, and it looks like I got everything down. It's just all about keeping tabs on everything. So with that said, I'm just gonna skip to the very end.
I don't think we were ever meant to be here.
A Grand Pulse Falci made this path.
Yep. I bet it's off digging more tunnels right now.
They seem different from all the Falci we've seen on Cocoon, you know? It's like they just plow through, without caring what happens around them.
That's true. Then again, we were able to build our village on land cleared by Falci. We lived alongside them, just like you do on Cocoon.
Oh yeah. This is just like Cocoon.
In a world this big, who knows what we'll find.
The Mahahahabara Subterrane. Well, I couldn't beat him. Eventually, after the stagger, it does like the super physical attack. It just does way too much damage, even with Protect on. So I gave up. But with that said and done, thanks for watching this part. Let's play Final Fantasy 13 with me, Opaque, part of the year Final Fantasy. Okay, thanks, bye.